Hi friends, good day to all. Today we are going to see UVA load problem on beam analysis. There are four different type of UVA load considered in beam problems. So here you can see in image four different type of UVA apply on the beam. And the image, first image you see in here, the load will be traversed from high to low. So this is the cantilever beam. At the second key point to third key point, the load will be gradually decreased from 7 kN to 3 kN/m. And if you see the another type here, at key point 1, 2, 3 to 4, the UVL will be start to gradually increase from 20 kN to 50 kN. And in the next problem, the UVL load will be gradually increased from 0 to 8 kN, that is 0 to high, low to high. And in another problem, the UVL load will be gradually decreased from 8 to 0, it is high to low. So we solve one by one each and every problem. Okay, as usual previous problem, you need to generate the directory for store your results, and also you need to mention the job name of your problem. So first you need to define your directory where all the results need to be, results and the file need to be stored. Go to browse and then choose your directory and then minimize the previous one, and this is the UVL load type 1, and then I choose on the specific folder where it need to be stored and then give OK. And then you need to mention here UVL type 1 and then again run it and then click the run button. Okay, now you need to give the title for your problem. Here UVL type 1 and then give OK. If you give plot and multi-plot means, sorry, you can see, okay, go to preference and then choose, this is the bending analysis of the beam, it should be comes under the category of structural analysis. Give OK and now replot it. Okay, sorry, and then go to preprocessor, choose the element type, add, edit, delete, add beam 2 node 188 and then give OK. Next you need to define the material properties of the beam. Go to material model, material properties, material model, and then structural, linear, elastic, isotropic material 2e⁵, and then Poisson ratio 0.3, and then give OK. And then next go to sections, beam, common section, and then this should be comes under the category of rectangular cross section of the beam. So through giving the beam cross section, we can find out the moment of inertia, and then give the breadth value as usual in the given question. The breadth value will be 200, height value will be 300. So you just give the breadth value 200, height value 300. So how many layers it need to be, discretize the volume of the beam, you can mention by NB and then NH. I want to 10 layer. This will give the accurate results of the deflection of the beam for the load act on it. So just preview the beam and its moment of inertia values calculated by the given breadth and height value of the beam. And then if you want to see the mesh view, how much layer it will be discretized, give mesh view. You can visualize the mesh view of the volume of the beam and then give OK. And then give right click replot. Wait a minute. Okay, next we need to create a model of the beam. So how many key points required to create the model of the beam? 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. So totally we require 5 key points. First key point located 2000 mm from origin, second key point located 5000 from origin, and third key point which is located from 7000 mm from origin, fifth key point which is located from 5, 7, 9,000 mm from the origin. As usual, we need to go 10,000 mm from origin. Sorry. Okay. So we generate the model of the beam. Go to modeling. After completing the section, go to modeling. Create key points in Active CS. Give the first key point location. It will be the origin. So give apply. And then second key point, and give the value. What is the value? It is 2000 mm. Then give 2000, and then apply. And then next, third key point location, it will be located 5000 mm, and then give apply. Oh sorry, I just give the same value. So if you want to replace the wrong commands given, wrong commands or wrong key points, you need to go to delete option, select key point, and then pick all the key points were deleted, and then again go to create key points in Active CS 1 and 0, and then 2000. Third key point will be located in 5000, and then give apply. And then fourth key point, which is located at 7000 mm, apply. And then fifth key point, which is located at 10,000 mm, and then give OK. And then go to front view of the beam. Okay. And then next, you need to construct the line in between those key points. Go to lines, go to straight line, select the first key point and the second key point, then select the second one and then the third one, and then select the third one and then select the fourth one, and then fourth one and then fifth one, and then give OK. You construct the beam now. Next, we need to discretize the beam. Here in my session, I just took 1000 elements to discretize the beam. So likewise, I discretize means I cannot get the result clear color image of the result. So I just give 10 elements. So go to mesh tools, lines, pick all the beam elements will be picked, and then I just, for understanding purpose, I just give you can give 10 elements. Okay, therefore you can clearly visualize the image results, color image results, and then give OK. And then go to again mesh tool, and then mesh, pick all. Okay, so for viewing your discretization of the beam, go to plot, go to lines. You can see the discretization of the beam elements into 10 segments. And then next, we need to apply the load. So totally how much load here apply? One UVL load, one moment load, which is acting anti-clockwise. We need to give the positive value, 40,000 newton mm. And then last activity key point, there is a point load acting 30 kilonewton. So next, we need to apply the load. Go to loads, analysis type. So obviously it is a static analysis, and then close the mesh toolbar, and then give OK. And then next, go to define loads, apply structural, and this is the beam of cantilever. So this is the key point origin is rigidly fixed, and then go to on structural displacement, on key point, choose the left one, and then give apply, and then all degrees of freedom, and then give OK. Next, we need to apply the point load and then moment load. So for that, you go into structural, force or moment, and then on key points. So first we apply the moment load, which is located at key point 2, 3, 4. Fourth key point, it will be the moment load will be at 2, 3, and then fourth one, and then give apply. And then give the value as moment about z, that is the moment will be act along z axis in the anti-clockwise direction. So you just give the value as positive value. For clockwise means it is negative value, 40 into e to the power 6 newton per mm. For solving the problem, we need to solve it in the units of SI unit, that is mm, newton mm, and then second, and then 40 e to the power 6, and then give OK. So here you can see the load, moment load, which is in anti-clockwise direction will be applied. And then next again click the key points and then choose the fifth key point and then give apply, and it will be the axial load, that is along y axis. The value, what is the value, which is also 30 kilonewton, 30 into e to the power 3, and then give OK. So next we need to give the negative value. So you need to you can delete the load by going delete option. So all load data, and then give, you can select individual load, point load, structural force or moment on key point, on which key point the load need to be delete, you just pick it and then give OK. That all the loads on the key point will be deleted, and then give OK. And then next go to again load, define loads, apply structural force or moment on key points. You can choose the last key point where we need to apply the y-axis load, and then give OK, and it will be the negative value, minus 30 into e to the power 3, and then give OK. It will act downwards. So next we need to apply the pressure load, that is UVL, from key point 2 to key point 3. So there is a two way we can use apply the UVL. One is through commands, and is similar triangle properties we can find a load for individual element. So we see this thing while completing all the problems. So now we go with the commands. So here you can look the commands. So this is the command. I already discretized my beam into 1000 elements. Now I need to change it as a 10 elements. So this is the command you need to use to discretize the beam for applying the UVL load. Just copy the command from my PPT, which is you can find out below the link, and then paste it anywhere, or else you can paste it in your command window. Before that you need to edit it. Okay, and then I need to give the my command, and then okay, and total number of elements, how much I have, I have 10 elements. Here 10 is completed, and this is the 11th element to 20th element. So just specified as location 11 to 20. Okay, and this is the shear, this is the SF beam. It is the SF beam, and then K, it is the element, and then key load, key factor 2, and this is the pressure load, and how much it vary, 7 to 3 kilonewton. So here you can see 7 minus K minus 10 elements, that is element 11. Total how much elements I have? 10 elements. And then this will be 20. And this will be 10 elements. 7 minus 4. I got 3 at the end. Here you need to mention as 10. Because it is the before end element, that is 10. K minus 10. That is this element. K minus 10, and then starts from 11 to, and then after go up to 10 element, that is 20 elements, up to 20 elements. Now the command is completed. So you can copy all the command lines, and then just copy and then paste it on your command window in a ANSYS user interface screen. Go to paste, and then click enter. The load will be applied. So clearly visualize, go to plot, go to multi plot. You can see how the load will be uniformly distributed over between the key point 2 to 3, that is 7, to 3 here. We complete all the load data. Next, go to solution. Go to solution, solve, current tell us, and then give OK. The solution will be calculated for the deflection of the beam. And then go to general post processor, plot results, deform shape, deform plus undeformed. And then I can see my deformation of the beam for the load acting. It is 223.624 mm. So to store the results, go to file, report generator, and then choose the location where it need to be stored. UVL load type 1, analysis file, and then results. On results, it need to be stored. Give OK, and then give OK. And then choose the snap of your deflection. Deform shape, give OK. And then you can name it, but the deflection of B. And then give OK. If you want to see the animation result, give animation capture. It is a deformed shaped. And then give OK. And then number of frames you can enter. How many frames you record, that number of frames you can give. I record 10 frames. And then deform plus undeformed shape. And then give OK. So the results will be stored on a respective directory. And then give close. You can go on the respective directory, go to results, and this is the animation sequence images for the deflection of the beam. I can get the deformed and undeformed shape. Okay, next we see the another results. Go to your ANSYS user interface screen, and then I want to get the shear force and then bending moment calculation. For that I need to define the elements. Whenever you go to ANSYS online help window, you can search for the beam 188 element, and in beam 188 element, what are the elements can be choosed for to find out the bending moment and then shear force. Go to element table, define table, add, and then by sequence number you just give 3, and then just give by sequence number. I will tell later what are all these to find out the bending moment shear force. 6, and then next choose by sequence number, and then 16, and then next 19. You need to specify the 19, and then give 19, and then give OK. Okay, so 3 and 16 generally used for to find out the bending moment diagram for the beam problem, and 6 and 19 generally used to find out the shear force of the beam problem. Next, go to plot results, contour plot, and then line element results. Choose SMIC 3 and SMIC 16, and then give OK. You can get the bending moment diagram. So you can also get the maximum bending moment, which is -0.450 e to the power n newton meter. Newton mm. And then you can again go to 3 and then 19. 6 and then 19, you can get the shear force diagram. This is my shear force diagram for the load act on the beam. And then, so you can generate the result by using the result generator. Go to file, report generator, and then on results, it need to be captured. And then you can name that, this is will be bending moment. And then give OK. And then if you want to see the shear force report, shear force on your report, go to 6, select SMIC element table inode and jnode 6 and 19, and then give OK. And then you can get the shear force. And also go to file, report generator, results append, and then choose camera image, and then you can mention a shear force. And then give OK, and then give close. And then next you want to see the degrees of freedom vector sum, that is total displacement on x, y, z, degrees of freedom solution, displacement vector sum, and then give OK. So this is my displacement vector sum results. So if you want to, that is, this is the maximum deflection of the beam, 223.624 mm. This is the maximum deflection here occurred. And then choose file and then go to report generator, effect results, degrees of freedom, vector sum, DOF, vector DOF, degrees of freedom, degrees of freedom sum, sum results. And then give OK and then close. And then if you want to see the three-dimensional deflection of your beam, you can go to plot control, style, size and shape, and enable the display of elements. You can see the three-dimensional view of your beam. Okay. Next, if you want to see the stress report, you can go to nodal solution and then displacement vector again, and then go to close this and then go to stress and then choose one mesh stress and then give OK. You can get the stress result as the Newton per mm square will be occurred at the support reaction support area, that is 152.5 Newton per mm square. This is the maximum stress and this is the minimum stress occurred here. And you can also generate the report generator by using, you can also generate the result by generate the report by using the report generator. And if you want to see the animation, go to plot control, animate, and then deformed results, and then go to stress and then one mesh sequence and then give OK. So this is the way you can store your results for your report generation purpose, and then give OK and close. And then if you want to see the reaction reaction support, that is RA, reaction support value, you can again enable your 2D view of your beam and then give OK. Go to front view and then go to list results, nodal solution. Okay, first we need to find out the reaction solution. Go to reaction solution, all structure force, and then give OK. At node 1, I have the reaction force, that is 40,000 Newton. This is my reaction force at the node 1. Okay. So go to file, print, and choose Microsoft print PDF and then give OK and choose the respective folder where it need to store. And then you choose to under results it need to be stored, and then give reaction result, reaction result, RESUL. Okay, you need to choose the directory where it need to be stored. On the respective directory under results, it need to be stored. Give save OK. Okay, and then give close. And then if you want to see the nodal results of individual element, that is degrees of freedom vector sum or also degrees of stress result, you can go to plot results, contour plot. Sorry, you just go to list results, nodal solution, and then degrees of freedom vector sum, and then give OK. You can see the individual element results. This also you can select this total we have 44 nodes. So on the 44 nodes, what is the deflection along x, y, z will be given, and then just give file, print, save as on the respective directory, and then you can give DOF sum. And then give OK. Then give close. Thank you all. In next problem, we see the okay. The second problem is gradually increasing. That is 20 kilonewton to 15 kilonewton. It will be gradually increased. So what is this kind of beam? This is the overhanging beam. So next we will see how the shear force and then bending moment diagram calculated for the overhanging beam with uniformly varying load. So we will discuss the second UVL type load. Choose the directory as usual. And then assign the title of the project. UVL type 2. Then go to preference, structure. Then go to preprocessor, element type, add any delete, add beam element to node 188 and then give OK. Next go to material properties, material model, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic to e to the power 5 and then Poisson ratio should be 0.3 and then give OK and then close this window. Next you need to define the cross section of the beam. Go to beam, go to comment section and this is the rectangular cross section. Breadth will be 300, height will be 200 and then give the number of layers, how much it need to be, the volume need to be discretized. Then I just give 10, then 10, and then preview. I can get the moment of inertia, IXX, IYY, IZ value. And then if you want to see the mesh view, you can get the mesh view. And then give OK. And then next I need to define my construction of the beam. Go to key points. So total how much key points I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 total I have. 6 key points which is located on the distance of 0, 2000, 3000, 9000, 10000 and then 12000. On this length the key points are also located. So we will generate the key points as usual. Go to create key points in active CS and then first key point location will be 0 and then give apply. And then what is the second key point value location? That is 2000. Then give 2. Then give the value as 2000 and then give up. And then what is the third key point location? It will be 3000 and fourth key point is 9000. 3000. Then give up. And what is the code fourth key point location? It is 9000. Fourth key point location will be 9000. And then what is the fifth key point location? It will be 10000. Then give 10000. Then give apply. And then what is the sixth key point location? It will be 12000. Okay. And then give okay. So total we created 6 key points. Next we connect them with lines. Go to lines and then straight lines. Choose lines. First key point and then second point and second, third, third and fourth, and then fourth and fifth, and then fifth and sixth. Okay, we complete it and then give OK. Next, we need to discretize the beam into fine elements for calculating the deflection of the beam for the load. So, go to meshing, mesh tool, and then select the line set and give the picker. And then I just discretize into 10 elements. Give number of element division as 10, then give OK. And then go to mesh tool and then mesh and then pick all. So all the things will be discretized. Go to plot and then lines. You can see the deformation of the discretization of the beam element. And then next we need to apply the loads. Go to loads, analysis type, new analysis and then static analysis. Give OK. And then go to load, define loads, apply structural. Just look at the image. So what are the loads we have? Point load, UVL load, moment load in anti-clockwise direction, and this is the overhanging beam. So here I have the hinged support, all the degrees of freedom arrested except moment about, rotation about Z. Here I have the roller support, so I have only arrested the deflection in the Y direction. All the things will be all the things that is UX, UZ are free, and then rotation X, rotation Y, rotation Z also free. There is a displacement on that, that is rotation about X, Y, Z all happen, and then movement about X and Z also happen whenever the load act on the beam. Okay, we will define the loads now. Okay, first we apply the point load and then moment load. Okay, just choose first we define the constraints for the beam. Okay, structural displacement on key points. So where it will be constrained at key point 1, key point 2, key point 2 will be rigidly fixed. So choose on key points and then apply, sorry, choose the second key point. This is my second key point and then apply except rotation about Z, all the things will be rigidly fixed. And then give OK. And then next on key point, and where it is applied, 2, 3, 4, fifth key point. Just on key point, this will be 2, 3, 4 and the fifth key point. And then select apply. And then it will be only arrested in the UY, only displacement along Y, only degrees of freedom, UY only arrested. Remaining degrees of freedom are freed. And then give OK. So next we need to apply the point load. Go to point and moment load. Go to force and moment on key point and select. We first apply the moment load, which is in anti-clockwise direction, 40 kilonewton meter. You can take in as 40,000 newton mm, that is 40 into e to the power 6 newton mm. Okay, 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power 3, therefore 10 to the power 6. So it is in positive, it is anti-clockwise direction. It is located on the fifth key point. Sorry, I just wrongly give the constraint. You can delete this constraint. Go to delete structural displacement on key point. This need to be deleted. Okay, and then all degrees of freedom. And then we give only UY only we will arrest it. Give OK. It will be removed. And then again go to apply structural displacement on key points. We will apply at the last. Here it will be applied at the last only. I forgot to give. And then give OK. And then UY only arrested. And then here the moment load will be acted. Go to force and moment on key point and choose that fifth key point. And then give OK. And it is moment about the Z. And then 40 e to the power 6, and then give OK. The moment load will be applied here, and then there is a point load acting at the key point 1. So what is the value? 30,000 newton, 30 into e to the power 3, and then choose force on moment on key point, choose this location, and then give apply, and just give minus 30 e to the power 6, and then give OK. Sorry, we apply moment load. It is a point load. So just go to delete load, structural and force and moment on key point. Just choose it and then delete it. Therefore, it is a moment load. It is moment about Z. And then delete. That load will be deleted. And then go to apply structural force and moment on key points. Choose that load and then give OK. And this will be the FY, and this will be 30 into e to minus 30 into e to the power 3, sorry, e to the power 6, I think that is 30 kilonewton, and then give OK. Okay, we will apply the moment load and then point load. Next we apply the UV load. You can use this formula, and then here for apply the UV load, here I give 10 segmented into 10 elements. So the load will be apply from this where it is starts. It is start from key point 1, 2, 3 to 4. It is gradually increased from 20 to 50 kilonewton. Okay, so I choose the element 10, 20 and then 30 to 40. It will be moves from 31 to 40. So you need to convert this thing into 31 to 40. I just divided into 10 elements, 31 to 40, and then therefore 20 plus 30 will 20 to 50. Okay, and then divided by here 10, and this will be the 31, and this will be 30. That is the previous element where there is no load. From that, it will be automatically calculated to apply the gradual increase of the UVL load. Just copy it and edit it on the separate place. This will be 31 and this will be 40 and this will be 31 and this will be 10 and this will be 30 and this will be 10. Okay, copy the commands. Then place it on the ANSYS user interface command window. Then key OK. The load will be applied here. Wait a minute. It will be applied on the wrong location. It need to be applied here. I will find out. Sorry, it is the element from 21 to, that is 10, 20, 21 to 30. I wrongly give the value over there. Just go to delete structural pressure on elements. Go to box selection and remove that. Okay, and then give OK. Then load key factor 2. Then give OK. And then go to plot, multi plots. You can again get the thing. And then go to again edit your command. This will be 21 to 30. And this will be 21. And the previous element where it starts from 21. Therefore, it just to be 20. And this will be 10 elements, 20 plus 30, 50 at the end, 20 to 50. 20 plus 30 at the end, 20 to 50. So just copy it. And then again, paste it to your ANSYS user interface window. Then give enter. So it is apply here. Then go plot and then multi plots. It will be gradually increased from 20 to 50 on key point 21 to key point 30. Okay, we complete all the load. Next, we will see the results. Go to solution, solve, current LS, and then give OK. And solution is done. Next, go to general post process, plot results, deform save, deform plus undeform, give OK. You can see the overhang being deflection for the UVL point load and moment load acting on it. So if you want to get the CFO's result, go to element table, define table, add, edit, delete, and then same way you need to by sequence number 3, and then you can mention as BMD, bending moment. Okay, and then apply. It will be labeled as bending moment, and then 3 and 6 8. And then this would be also bending moment, BMD, and then give apply. Sorry, BMD1, BMD2. I just need to give BMD2, 16. Okay, and then BMD, this will be, I need to delete it. This need to be, I need to delete it, and then I just add BMD1 by sequence number, this will be 3, and then give apply, and then SFD, CFO's diagram, SFD, and this should be 6, and SFD1, and then give apply, and then next SFD2, and this should be 19 6 and 19, then give OK. So we just labeled it, what are the elements for CFOs and then bending moment calculation, and then go to plot results, contour plot, list element table, choose BMD1, BMD2, and then give OK. You can get the bending moment. You can use the report generators to store your result, and then where it need to be stored, under the results file it need to store, and then give OK, get the snap, and then give OK. It will be stored on the respective result direct. And then if you want to see the CFOs, the SFD1 and then SFD2, and then give OK. Then I get the CFOs results. Also it can be stored in the result directory. And then give snaps, and then you can label it as a SFD, CFO's diagram, SFD, and then give OK. Then close. So if you want to see the displacement vector sum, equal to degrees of freedom displacement vector sum. Also you can see the displacement vector sum of your UVL load on the overhanging beam. So the maximum deflection is 39.080 mm. It is occur here. And also you can get the vector product results. Go to vector plot, predefined, and then DOF solution, and then give. Okay, you can get the vector plot results. So if you want to see stress result, and then give. Okay. Sorry, it is eliminated. We cannot find the stress. We can only get the degrees of freedom. We can get the strain, total strain, principal total strain. We can get. Sorry. Contour plot, nodal solution, stress, one Mrs. stress. Can find out the one Mrs. stress. So for clearly viewing the stress results, you can enable the three-dimensional view. Then enable it. You can see the maximum stress is 119.63 Nm/mm². It is occurred here. Maximum stress occurred here. And then next you can see the strain results. Go to total mechanical strain, one Mrs. strain, and then you can get the maximum strain, right? That is 0.59 e⁻³. That is, the strain does not have the no unit. And then you can generate it on your respective cell director. Thank you. Next we will see the zero. So next we see the third type of UVL load act on the beam. So this is the simply supported beam. So here the load will be gradually increased from 0 to 8 kN/m, and the beam length is 1000 mm. And we will see how it will be, how to find out the shear force and bending moment diagram for the simply supported beam for the UVL act on it from 0 to 8 kN. So you need to define the directive where it need to be stored under UVL type. UVL type 3 need to be stored, ANSYS file, and then give OK, and this would be UVL type 3, and then give run, and you need to change your title name, change title, UVL type 3, and then give OK, go to preference, structural, OK, preference, element type, add, edit, delete, add, beam element, 2 node 188, give OK, give close, then choose material property, material model, this is the steel, I just give the steel element properties, 2 × e⁵, and then 0.3, it is a Poisson ratio, and then give OK, and then next need to go to sectioning, beams, common section, and this is the rectangular cross section, width will be 300, height will be 200, and then give number of layer 15, and this would be 20, and then give preview, and then give the mesh view, and then give OK, and then next you can construct the beam, modeling, create key points, so you can replot it, go to inactive CS, you can give first key point. There are two key points only we have. One and then two, the second key point located 1000 mm from origin. One will be 0, and then give apply, and then two will be 1000, and then give OK, and the next go to lines, straight line, so first and second, and then give OK. And then next we need to discretize into number of elements. Go to meshing, and then mesh tool, and then select the line, set line, and then pick call, and then give number of element division as 10. So just give 10. So if you give 100 means it will be discretized into 10 elements, or else if you give 100 means it will also discretize into 10. So 100 200 300 400 10 elements, it will be automatically discretized. Anyone you can give, and then give OK, it automatically 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, so total 10 elements, it will be automatically discretized. Again click the mesh tool, and then select the mesh, and then pick all, and you can see you are missing. Go to plot lines, you can see the discretization of the beam. Next we will apply the load, and then so for that you can copy this formula and paste it on the window. So just copy somewhere, and then I need to edit it. I discretize into 100 element, I divided into 10 elements. So I just go to somewhere on the board screen, and then just no color. This should be no color, okay, and this should be element 1 to 10, okay. This is element 1 to 10, and this will be 0 to 8, and this will be 1, and this will be 100, and this will be 10 element, and this also should be a 10 element, okay. And this is load key factor 2, and then automatically we cannot apply through these loads analysis type. We need to select this static analysis, okay, then close this window, and this would be the static analysis, and then define loads, apply structural pressure, and if you choose on beams and then box method, if you apply pressure load here, okay, I guess just give okay, and this will be load key factor, I node will be 0, and then J node will be 8. What is the value? We have 8 kilonewton per meter, that is kilonewton, that is 18 to 10 to the power 3 divided by 10 to the power 3, therefore 8 newton per mm. Okay, if I give 8 means, what will be happen? 0, 8. This is wrongly defined the UVL load. So if you go to plot, multiplot, this is wrongly defined the UVL load. So we use one method called command based method, another one is the similar triangular properties. In next video we will see how to use the similar triangular properties, how to apply the UV load. That is, you need to mention the individual gradual increase of values 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. Likewise, the load will be increased from 0 to 8. Therefore, you can calculate it from similar triangle properties. So now we will start with command, how to apply it. So just delete all the load data. Go to delete all load data. Give OK. Then go plot, multiplots. And then first we need to define it is as a simply supported beam. Go to displacement on key points. So select these two key points and then give apply. And then UX, UY, UZ will be arrested, rotation X, rotation Y will be arrested, there is moment will be happen at rotation about Z whenever the load acting on it, and then just copy this comment and then paste here, okay. Go to plot, multiplot, it will be vary from 0 to 8 newton per mm. So now you can solve the solution to get the results of deflection of the beam. Go to solution, go to solve, and then current LS, and then give OK. And the solution is done. And then next you can see the shear force and then bending moment results. And then go to general processor, plot results, deform shape, deform plus, and deform shape. You can get the deform plus and deform. As usual, you can define the element table 3 and 16 for bending moment, and then 6 and 19 for shear force. So you can find it here on the PPT. 3 and 16 for bending moment, 6 and 19 for shear force. Go to define, the maximum deflection is 0.70 e to the power minus 03 mm. So go to element table, define table, add BMD1, and this will be by sequence number, it should be 3. And then BMD2, then it should be by sequence number 16, and give a play, and then by sequence number this should be this is shear force diagram, SFD1. This would be 6 and 19. Then SFD2. 4, it should be 19. You will give OK, close. And then you can obedient the shear force and then bending moment results. Go to counter plot, line element results, BMD1, BMD2. That is 3 and 16. So you can get the bending moment diagram. And then go to line results, shear force 1, shear force 2. And then you can get the shear force results. So all the things you can store in your respective directory through file report generator. Go to report generator and then give OK. Sorry, you need to choose the particular result file. Okay, and then take the shear force. This is my shear force diagram. Yes, definitely. And then give OK and then close. If you want to see the bending moment results, if you want to store the bending moment 1, then bending moment 2, and then give OK. So you can get the bending moment and then store it on the respective directory. Then BMD. Then give OK. And then if you want to see store the animation results, I want to see the deformed result. Degrees of freedom vector sum, and then give OK. So it will be stored all the sequence of displacement of the vector sum of the beam for the UVL actoni. So you can get the degrees of freedom vector sum. So thank you all. Next we will see gradually decrease load. Now we look the fourth problem. You can go to the fourth problem. Go to ANSYS. And then choose the directory where it need to be stored. We'll type 4. Just choose the directory where it need to be stored. Just follow my instruction. Go to file, change title, UVL type 4. And then give OK. And then preference, structural, preprocessor, element type, add, edit, delete, add, beam element, 20098. Give OK, close. Next, go to material property, material model, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic, 2 into e to the power 5 for steel, and then poison ratio 0.3 for steel. Then give close. Next, go to section, beam, common section, and this is the rectangular cross section. And the breadth will be 300, and then height will be 200, and the number of volume layer along breadth will be divided into 20, number of volume layer along height will be divided into 15. I just give approximately preview, and this is the IXS IIY value. It will be calculated for the given breadth and height. And then I can see the mesh view and then give OK. And then next you can go to modeling, create, right click, replot. You can get the screen again. Key points in active CES, key point 1 will be located at x at 0 and key point 2 located at the distance 1000 mm from origin along x. And then give OK. And then next generate the line between the straight line on first key point and then second key point and then give OK. And then next you can meshing, go to mesh tool and then lines and then pick all, and then it will be divided into 10 elements. So I just give the element, each and every element length will be 100, and then give OK. And then again choose mesh tool and then mesh and then pick all. All the lines will be picked and then go to plot lines. You can see this will be 100, this will be 100, this will be 100. So I can get the 10 elements along the 1000 mm length of the line. Next we need to apply the constraint. So this is the simply supported beam. Go to loads, analysis tab, new analysis, static analysis, close the mesh tool and then give OK. Next go to define loads, apply structural displacement on key points, select the first and last key points. And then give OK and select UX, UY, UZ, rotation X, rotation Y, Therefore, this is the simply supported beam. There is a deflection along. Moment about Z will be happen whenever the load act on it. So leave rotation about Z and then give OK. And the next go to force and moment. Sorry, next we need to apply the pressure load. We cannot use this to apply for the UVL. So we have the similar triangle properties. You need to find out the individual element gradual upgradation of the load. So for that we can go for the formula. Wait a minute. So this is the problem 8 to 0. We need to choose the formula. You just copy the formula and then re-edit it for our element distribution in our beam. Go to Word. And just give 10 elements. And this would be load key factor 2. And this would be 1 to 0. And number of elements would be 10. Number of elements would be 10. That's enough. 8 to 0. 8 minus k minus 1 into 8 divided by 10. That is 8 minus 8, 0. At the end, it will be 0. 8 minus 8, at the end, it will be getting 0. Just copy the command and just place it in your ANSYS user interface window. Give enter. The load will be gradually decreased. So go to plot and then multiplots. You can see from 8 to 0, it will be gradually decreased. Go to solution, solve, current LS, give OK. The solution will be done. And then go to general post processor, plot results, deform state, deform plus undeform state. You can get the deflection of the beam for the UVL, that is 0.700 into e to the power 03 mm. So report generator, as usual, you can generate the report on the respective directory. On the result, it need to be stored, and then give this, it will be deformed state, deform state, and then give OK. As usual, you can get the reaction result. Go to list results, reaction solution, all structured force, Fy and Fx can be find out. And then all structure force, you can get the Fx and then that is Fy along reaction 1 and then reaction 2, 266.7 newton, 133.3 newton. So you can save it on the respective directory. So it will become under UVL type 4. Result. Reaction result. Save it. And then you can also get the degrees of freedom vector sum results. Go to degrees of freedom, displacement vector sum, and then give OK. And then you can get the individual element. Total 10 elements we have, 1 to 10. So what is the individual element displacement vector sum along UI, UZ. So you can get the individual vector sum and you can save it on the respective directory. This would be DOF vector sum and then give OK. Thank you. Well, next we will see the second method of UVL applied over the, that is using similar triangle properties, how we can apply the